The House overwhelmingly passes a resolution condemning anti-Semitism and other bigotry. Democrats spent the week fighting over the proper response to the controversial words of a freshman representative, Ilhan Omar. Capitol Hill correspondent Jason Calvi joins us with more. Good evening, Jason.
Good evening, Wyatt. 10 days ago, Omar suggested Americans who support Israel have dual allegiances. The House resolution doesn't explicitly name her. It does condemn anti-Semitism, anti-Muslim discrimination, and bigotry against minorities. President Trump calls it disgraceful and accuses Democrats of becoming the anti-Israel party, as critics say this final resolution is watered down.
The yeas are 407, the nays are 23.
All Democrats voted yes.
What we're doing here today is making it unequivocally clear to the public that no one has the support to engage in discrimination and racism and anti-Semitism.
But still, these Jewish Democrats criticize the resolution.
The way the representative from Minnesota spoke, then we need to single it out and say we will not tolerate it.
We are having this debate because of the language of one of our colleagues. Language that suggests that Jews like me, who serve in the United States in Congress, and whose father earned a Purple Heart fighting the Nazis in the Battle of the Bulge, that we are not loyal Americans?
Here's what Representative Omar said.
I want to talk about the political influence in this country that says it is okay for people to push for allegiance to a foreign country.
Senator Bernie Sanders defends Omar, saying, "We must not, however, equate anti-Semitism with legitimate criticism of the right-wing Netanyahu government in Israel." Representative Omar sits on the House Foreign Affairs Committee.
Any member who seeks to serve on especially the Foreign Affairs Committee should be removed from that committee and censured for expressing anti-Semitic views. And it's disgraceful that the majority did not directly deal with this issue head on.
Both Republicans Andy Barr and Steve Scalise voted yes, but are still critical.
It condemns death threats received by Jewish and Muslim members of Congress. Why, interestingly, were death threats to other members of Congress left out? I surely can speak to that.
The Catholic League also criticizes this resolution for not dealing with what it calls anti-Catholic comments made by Democrats. The document does mention questions of dual loyalty leveled against President JFK. Some were worried his Catholic faith would cause him not to be a loyal president. Wyatt?
Capitol Hill correspondent Jason Calvi reporting. Thanks, Jason.